2005, I started to get a little bit bored with working in theory of computation and doing computer science stuff. Decided that I felt like I really wanted to do something for the community because I was really enjoying living in Athens. So I usually don't talk about myself in the third person. I think it's originally started by me and Michael Lucker and Michael Moore. So I got in touch with these two friends of mine. Mike, and I really wish they were here tonight, but Michael Moore was a graduate student at MCS department at UGA. Michael Lucker, you guys that may have heard of him, he was known as Luke Tan around town. He was a local folk singer. And we kind of got together and we decided that we really, really wanted to do something for the community. It happened because I was volunteering with Bike Athens. You guys familiar with Bike Athens? Yeah, so Bike Athens is a bike recycling program, and I was working with them and realized that I really sucked at fixing bikes. So, and I knew a little bit about computers, so we figured we would try this computer recycling thing out, the same thing. We had our original meetings at the happy hour, and then at the coffee shops, and then eventually this great organization we heard about, have you guys heard about Common Ground? Those of you that aren't involved with 3IT? So we heard about this organization that would give us their 501c3 status and would sponsor us and let us take donations and actually give us a place to work, which was pretty awesome. So it wasn't too long after that when we held our first open hours and talked about what our goals were. And our goals were really that technology should be free and or open, and that everybody should have a friend that knows about technology, so that when people needed help with technology, they had a place to go. They didn't have to drive out to Best Buy and potentially get ripped off. They could come to us and we would be the honest people that could help them through their problems. And we could also tell them about free and open source software, which is pretty awesome stuff. You guys are preaching to the choir here, I think. So the very first thing that we did is that we started holding open hours, and we held open hours 8 hours a week on Sundays from 1 to 5, on Mondays from 6 to 8, and on Wednesdays from 6 to 8. We're still holding open hours on Wednesdays from 6 to 8 and on Sundays from 1 to 5. This picture is actually that's me and Michael Moore at one of our first open hours. This is, and the picture was actually taken by Michael Lucton. We didn't have any volunteers. All we had was a few computers in Common Ground's closet, and so we just went to work on them immediately. We started helping nonprofits because, again, we didn't have a lot of computers to work on. We worked with Common Ground, of course. We built them a computer lab, and we started having classes. We worked with the Athens Area Homeless Shelter, the Economic Justice Coalition, who has been helping us now for a long time, Casa de Amistad, and we were basically refurbishing computers. But it wasn't very long after we started working at Common Ground that word got out, and people started bringing us a ton of machines. So we started getting more and more machines in and more volunteers. And in summer of 2006, we decided to start the recycling program, which is really the big thing that we do now. And the idea was based on the Free Geek model, which most of you probably have heard of, where you can volunteer for 12 hours and earn a computer. We also were recycling unusable parts. And the first week, we put an ad in the flagpole. It wasn't the classified section. It was the I can't remember which section, but it was like this big. We put an ad. Hey, do you want a free computer? If you do, send an email to. And I put my email address there, which was a bad idea because I got this huge number of emails. We had a waiting list the first week, which was amazing. We had I think 10 people we let in. We had probably 20 people that wanted to get in into our program, and we started. We started doing this, and these are pictures from our first summer of recycling when things were much different than they are now. So for those of you that are doing things now, you missed all the days when we were actually taking the steel off of computers because we were selling the steel to a local steel recycler before we started talking to these creative recycling who's working with us now. But it was a regimen program. It was a lot different than it is now, where people would come in the first 4 hours, they would spend, you can see the picture in the top left corner, they would actually be ripping the steel off of these computers, putting them in boxes, and then the second 4 hours, they would spend actually testing RAM and trying to get stuff working, and then the last 4 hours, they would build their own computer and take it home. In fact, you can see a picture of Annette Wiggs down there in the bottom left-hand corner. He's still a volunteer sometimes. That's kind of interesting. She comes in and hangs out pretty regularly. So it was a much different thing. Over time, things changed a little bit because We started working with recycling companies out of Atlanta. They would actually drive up and pick up our recycling and pay us for it, like 3 cents a pound, I think. And within the first year, we got 30 computers out in the community through our recycling program and through a nonprofit grant program. But we had over 1,000 volunteer hours, and we had recycled over 1 ton of recyclables, which is pretty amazing considering we weren't selling computers at that point. It was when we realized how many computers we had and how slow they were going out, that's when we started selling them for $25 in our Computers for Kids program. So we started the Computers for Kids program, and then later the school partnership that I think we started right before I left, but then Brian and Clint worked on some. And before long, it became 1,500 computers that we've gotten out in the community, which is actually a statistic that I think that we should all be very, very proud of. And these days, we have 41 active volunteers and an active staff of about 10 to 15 people. And we're still open Wednesdays and Sundays. Actually, the Monday open hours stopped right before I left because we're having trouble staffing them. We have all kinds of stuff like sales nights, orientations, trainings, and special events. We still do the grant program and maintain computer labs around town. We have a thrift store so people can come in and get parts. If you don't know about us, please, before you go buy a video card at Best Buy, come to us first. We offer tech support to local nonprofits, and we participate in the community. Joel and Brian and Angel and I ran in the Nucci Space 5K, which was very, very exciting. But we also try to do things that we did as a Free IT Athens team, but we try to do stuff in the community that's pretty great. But that's basically it. So I'm glad, hopefully everybody kind of knows about the history a little bit, but if you want to ask me any other questions, I'm glad to answer them. I want to give, again, Brian Pitts. I started Free IT with the two other guys, but I always kind of felt like it was my baby to some extent, and when I left it was really heartbreaking and really scary for me because I was like, oh man, what's going to happen to Free IT Athens? And it just feels so good to come back 3 years later and have it still a thriving organization where so many people are involved. I mean, it's amazing. When there were three of us at the first open hours, and look at how many people are here right now. It's amazing. So thank you again, and everybody give yourself a big hand.